Hey guys, and welcome to another video. My name is Gym Pastor Montes, and today we'll be talking about the pros and cons of living in Bulgaria. Before we get started, make sure to hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell, and hit the like button as well. Helps a lot with the YouTube algorithm and is going to push this video out further to other audiences so they can also have the chance to see this. So I would very, very much appreciate your support. Without further ado, let's dive into the video. I moved here 6.5 years ago. I moved from Greece. I'm Greek. I moved out here. I started my business out here. And basically, most of my time was spent between Plovdiv and Sofia. Majority of the time in Sofia, but in the beginning I lived in Plovdiv as well. But everything I'll be talking about will be based on my experience in Sofia and not like all around Bulgaria. As far as the pros are concerned, if you're coming here on the basis of retirement, on the basis of opening up a business, or maybe on the basis of being a freelancer that wants to come here, work remotely, and like, you know, pay taxes here, I think you'll be awesome, right? Now, Bulgaria is very, very tax friendly. So we're talking about 10% corporate income tax, 5% on dividend distributions, very, very low, right? Very, very low. Then depending on how you structure it as a freelancer, we're talking about 7.5% tax. And I believe it's 5% taxes for dividends if you're coming here and getting dividends from abroad. So very low taxes. Again, depending on how you structure it, of course, hire an accountant once you're here, but these are some of the lowest taxes you're ever going to get access to. So that's awesome. Besides that, real estate, and generally lifestyle, is very, very cheap. And again, that includes real estate, transportation, groceries, utilities, even labor as well. Everything is very, very, very cheap. Generally, again, groceries very cheap. The quality I find quite decent. Some of my friends really hate the beef out here in Bulgaria in general. I don't have much of an opinion on that because I don't really eat beef. Anyways, in general, groceries are just fine quality-wise. Prices are decent. Utilities like electricity, water, everything is like very competitive and like quite lower than say Greece or Hungary. With that said, now, especially recently with the energy problems that the world has had, prices have gone up quite a lot. So I don't know where Bulgaria stands on that scale anymore. Like seeing the electricity prices recently have absolutely skyrocketed. So where do they stand now? I'm not really sure, right? Like where they stand on the world scale. Real estate prices, some of the best in the world, if you are ready to sit and scout for great deals. Now, when I say real estate prices, I'm not talking about you going out there and buying a property. I'm mainly talking about rentals. So you can get great, great deals on rentals. And of course, there's many variables, so I'm not gonna make specific examples. Like it depends on what location you choose. It depends on whether you want your place to be furnished or unfurnished, modern or, you know, an older building, or modern or, you know, more classic furniture. There's a bunch of things it depends on, so I'm not really gonna get into it in this video. All I'm saying is if you are ready and you have the patience to sit down and actually scout for a bunch of deals, there's a good chance you're gonna get yourself a great deal, whether it's like a more simple property or a property in the luxury section. Taxis and generally transportation in Bulgaria is quite easy and very, very cheap. Taxis will take you basically anywhere in Sofia for no more than 5 euros. That's awesome. There is a metro system I've barely ever used, but you know, that's also convenient as far as I hear. The data plans here are awesome. So basically I pay, I believe, 17.5 euros a month. I get unlimited data, 5G, 12,000 megabytes for roaming abroad, as well as unlimited calls here. And I believe it's like a couple hours of call time in some countries. It depends on like where. So I know I can call Greece, I can call like certain places. And typically they also bundle it with something else. So like they will give you like an HBO subscription on top of it. That like there's something like that. Generally very, very, very cheap. Bulgaria has wonderful parks. That's something that I love a lot. You can generally walk in like huge parks. Like people go there with their dogs and it's like, oh man, it's just beautiful. The city center is quite walkable, so I like that. The internet speed in Bulgaria is awesome. So basically we're talking about you're able to get 1 gigabyte a second if you want to. And of course that's an overkill, but if you wanted to get 1 or 200 megabytes a second, not a problem. That's totally fine and it's gonna be very, very cheap. I've been using A1 for those that are curious. I'm not really satisfied with A1. Like they have constant problems and the customer service hasn't been that great. So I'll just say that. And for my data, I've used Telenor. Telenor, I haven't had any problems, surprisingly. Like very rarely I'm gonna have a problem. Generally speaking, they have been quite easy to work with. Their application works well for the most part. And I say for the most part, because recently I needed to renew the contract and in theory I could do it through my phone on the app, but it had some problems and it wasn't allowing me to renew, but generally is just fine. Nightlife in Bulgaria is okay. Nothing crazy. Like it's not like in Dubai, for example, but it's like not non-existent. Lots of Bulgarians are quite content with the nightlife and they think like it's like extremely amazing. And I guess it would vary from person to person. So that's just my personal opinion. It's not like anything insane, but it's a decent nightlife. It's not like anything out of the world. Bulgaria has super beautiful nature, so if you want to hike or you want to take a few hours and go to the coast and go to like Varna or Burgas and like spend some time on the Black Sea, you can totally do so. During the winter, Bulgaria is very well known for their ski resorts, so you know you can go ski or do whatever, it's awesome, right? Or even if you're not into the sports and you just want to go to one of those resorts and actually just spend some time around beautiful environment, you can do so. I highly recommend it. Bulgaria has some of the most beautiful women in the world. And I know from experience, all right? Because I am with one right now. And let me tell you, amazing. But I think I would kind of wrap up, not to make it too long of a list, on the pros of Bulgaria, and we would jump into the cons. Though I mentioned that taxis are dirt cheap before, there's something to be said also that you kind of get what you pay for. So basically, a lot of times you're going to have taxi drivers that don't speak a single word of English. And I mean, that will typically be because they're like very, very old in some cases. And I have found that they don't really have a lot of consideration for whether you're okay, like in terms of like them smoking. So especially like if it's summer and they've been smoking all day and the car just smells awful. The optimal experience that I've found in terms of the cleanest taxis and the most people that speak English is with a company called Yellow. They're not sponsoring the video, though they should be. But anyways, Yellow is the main taxi company that I use. Decent prices. Again, you know, the taxis are relatively clean and the people speak English most of the times. So I think that's like the higher standard of Bulgaria. You need to be very careful around taxi and taxi companies in Bulgaria in general, just because there's a lot of like scam companies out there. So that's something you always need to be looking out for. But if you download like the Yellow Taxi app and you just use those, you're not gonna have any problems. The infrastructure around cleaning the city in general is not very ideal. I like how they maintain like the gardens in certain places and certain parks and like stuff like that. I think are very beautiful. But in general, Sofia is not a very clean city, unfortunately, because that's one of the big cons for me in general. As somebody that lived in the city center for a little while, that's something I strongly disliked. It's not a clean city. I wish they would do better when it comes to that. Landlords are not very dog friendly. I remember I was speaking to this real estate agent when I was like on the hunt on getting an apartment or a house, and she told me 97% of the landlords will not allow you to have a pet. And like we had a little argument about that. I was thinking, hey, look, if this statistic is really true, then we're talking about really narrow-minded people. And of course, 97% was a total exaggeration. But in my experience, I have found that a lot of people have some prejudice if you have a dog or you're younger. And to their defense, I have a friend who has a lot of properties here, and like I have seen the result of, you know, renting out to a lot of young people that are kind of irresponsible and things like this, and like they kind of trash the property sometimes. So to their defense, I understand that they would think that, okay, well, if you're younger, maybe you're not as responsible, but it's like very, very evident when you're out there and negotiating that that's a concern, right? And if you have a dog, good luck. A lot of times, it's not even a conversation for some folks out here. So if you have a dog, doesn't matter if it's like a 2 kilo dog or a 20 kilo dog, doesn't matter. In a lot of cases, having a dog will really limit your chances of getting an apartment or a house out here. Banks in Bulgaria can be quite terrible. Some of these banks are notorious for shutting down customers out of the blue and not really providing any reason why they're shutting down accounts. So I have seen that before. I've also had a hard time actually getting an account with some of these banks. So they won't give you any articulate reason or any specific reason on to why they don't want to work with you. They will just tell you, look, we have the right to not accept a customer, so we won't do it. And what I've found is that generally banking in Bulgaria has become quite harder over the last like 3 years or so. So if you're a foreigner, it turns out some of those banks will not give you an account. And like there was like a whole crackdown where they were like shutting down customers out of the blue, and most of them were foreigners. And like this is when we started picking up the pattern, and after speaking with a bunch of like accounting companies, accounting firms, they told me that across the board, the firms that they saw getting shut down the most were firms that are run by foreigners. So that sucks, right? If you're a foreigner coming to Bulgaria, which most likely is the case, then some of those banks you might have problems with. Which bank would I recommend the most? I probably have the best experience so far with Raiffeisen and Postbank. So these are the two that I would recommend the most. And UBB is okay so far. There is a branch I very much enjoy, and like the representatives there are great, but generally speaking, not super well run. Another very major one that I know most of the people out here have noticed is that customer service in Bulgaria can be quite bad, meaning that I have noticed that people are not very solutions oriented. Basically, if, especially like in hotels and places like that, and we're not talking about like 3-star hotels, we're talking about the 5-star hotels of Bulgaria, right? So if you start talking to somebody that can't actually help you and you go down the rabbit hole of, hey, look, we can't help you. I can't help you. I don't know the answer to that. You're done. You won't be able to get any help from this individual. It doesn't matter what position they're in. I found that to be quite frustrating. Again, this is like on any sector, banks, any company that I dealt with in general, the phone companies. So like I said, I haven't had any particular problems with Telenor, but if I need to go and actually visit a branch, not good. Like the same goes for like A1, same thing. It's very common that like people will hang up on you, and if they don't speak English, that's another thing. So if you're like calling a business to ask a legitimate question, there's like a good chance they might actually hang up on you just because you speak English. If the person doesn't feel confident they can answer, they'll just hang up and like not pick up the phone. I've had that experience many, many times. There's people here that make a joke that if you want somebody to stop bothering you in a store, like somebody, a representative comes up and you know, they want to help you, or they're like, you know, want to like be pushy about like helping you make a choice or something, like if you say something in English, that they will say, oh, okay, like just walk away. So if you want to turn them away, speak English to them. And that's a joke that they make out here. I think that if companies started having the standard of making sure that all of their staff speak English, that would actually help the community out quite a lot, right? Because there's a lot of foreigners that come out here. And there's really something, especially here in Bulgaria, lots of people will come and tell you, well, instead of the foreigners speaking English, you should learn Bulgarian. That's a whole debate I'm not gonna get into this video. But there is some resistance in actually pushing the country forward to making sure that everybody speaks English. So regardless of like age and things like this, I think that it's a necessity. And as the capital of a country, you should know English so you can service those that are here even temporarily, right? Like not just the residents. Restaurants out here are nice, but if you're looking for like fine dining or like Michelin star restaurants or anything like that, Bulgaria is not gonna be the place for you. You're not gonna find anything like that out here, and that's something you should keep in mind. If you like fine dining, even in Sofia, you have very, very, very limited options. Another thing would be that generally Bulgaria is quite corrupt on a bunch of different levels, right? So if we're talking about the politicians, or if we talk about even police, so it's very common that like police can be kind of predatory, and it like will stop you and try to find something wrong with you. And if you in some cases try to bribe them, which, by the way, I'm not saying you should, but I'm saying I know that people do that and they get away with it, and like they spend a little bit of money, whatever, like 10 to 25 euros, and the police officer lets them go. And generally, I think that's terrible, and unfortunately, that happens quite a lot here. When I first moved out here, they told me that that's not really the case anymore, and like they crack down on police officers that accept bribes and stuff like that, but I haven't really seen that. I have heard so many times of people telling me that, you know, this is still the case. The last thing, and that's kind of controversial, I know lots of people get hurt by this, and I have seen it time and time again. I've had this conversation, and generally seen other people have the conversation, is that the buildings in Bulgaria a lot of times cannot be very appealing. There's like old buildings everywhere, and kind of like there's like communist buildings everywhere still that are still up. Now, this is in Sofia. In Plovdiv as well, you can see that. In Varna and Burgas, like, you can see that. I'm not saying that the cities don't have their beautiful parts, right? Like, Sofia has very beautiful parts. Plovdiv has very beautiful parts. Burgas and Varna and, like, Veliko Tarnovo and, like, a bunch of those cities have great, great parts that you can visit and, like, you know, super beautiful places. But still, like, when you're flying in with a plane, the view is not that appealing. And generally, like, most of the parts that you go to, you're not really gonna love the place. An example I have is like Budapest, for example. Budapest is like the polar opposite. Anywhere you are in the city, it's majestic. They have maintained these old buildings. They have made sure that everything looks amazing. You're not really gonna find that in Bulgaria. And that's quite a shame. I guess these are most of the negatives that I would have to mention. Maybe I'm gonna get myself in some hot water here. Hopefully not. But if you enjoy the video, hit the like button. If you disagree with me on something, hey, look, let's discuss it. I'm happy to talk with you about my opinions and so on. So leave a comment down below. Let me know what you think. And yeah, guys, once again, make sure to hit the subscribe button as well and follow the channel. Very, very much appreciate your support. And I'll be seeing you guys on the next video.